A very warm welcome to all of you in this very special event. Welcome everyone. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome our principal, parents, staff and my beloved learners to the 4th annual concert of the primary section of CP Goenka International School. These difficult times have thrown open many doors of opportunity and learning for all of us. This first ever virtual concert is a step forward in embracing the new normal. Our learners have made us immensely proud by adapting so beautifully to this virtual space and participating wholeheartedly in this concert. Thank you everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a treat lined up for you. And to help me take you through this evening, I proudly introduce you to my co-host, the adorable Angad Mohale from grade 3B. Angad, take it away.
Thank you, Ms. Sophia, and a very good morning to all of you. My name is Angad, and it's a pleasure to welcome you all to our beautiful event today. Due to this pandemic situation, we are not able to meet everyone physically. Because of which, I miss my school, my teachers and my friends too. I know well that you miss them too, right? Hence, we decided to meet everyone on screen. Isn't that exciting? As we all know, our events are incomplete without blessings. Let us invoke the blessings of the Almighty by lighting the lamp of knowledge.
Mr. Sandeep Goenka and Mrs. Archana Goenka, Trustee CP Goenka Group of Schools, Ms. Deepa Bhushan, Director Group of Schools, distinguished guests, parents of the school, teachers and my dear students. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you to the school's first virtual annual concert. The past academic year has been one which was very busy, filled with unknown challenges. However, I'm very pleased to share that it was one filled with several new add-ons and higher bars to reach, one that created a conducive learning environment for the children in our care. Today, as I present to you the annual report of the school for the academic year 2021, I take this opportunity to thank God for all His blessings, guidance received from the members of the Governing Council, support received from you parents, and a special applause for the students and teachers. We are extremely proud of our students and staff who strive hard and walk the extra mile. In the year gone by, they sincerely did their best to take on the challenges head on, which were thrown at them, and each in his or her own right came out shining and victorious. We salute the never give up attitude of everyone. In the year 2020, we received quite a few accolades. CP Goenka Group Schools was ranked India's 5th most respected education brand by the Education World. CPGIS Oshiwara featured in the Times School Survey 2020 and was in the list of top ranked schools that follow the international curriculum. Spring Birds International was ranked among the top 3 schools in Mumbai, both in the categories of innovative teaching and parental involvement as per the Times School Survey 2020. 3 batches of students of the school in the past year sat for their board examinations, and we are very proud to share that they all cleared the exams. 72 students appeared for the March 2021 IGCSE exams. This year, we also witnessed our first batch of 14 students sit and clear the AS level examinations. Congratulations to all the achievers and rank holders. Children, you really made us very proud. Other students too won awards and made us proud. Arav Sawant of grade 8A was awarded a certificate of achievement by TED Ed Club for sharing an idea worth spreading. Sachet Galaya from IEDP Year 1 was awarded a certificate of excellence at the IMAN Digital Conference. Mehul Kumar of IEDP Year 2 was judged the best speaker at an international webinar organized by DSP Monar International School, Qatar. Deena Hingorani, again from IEDP Year 2, was part of a winning team in the Mental Health Advocacy Fair organized by Singhania School, Mumbai. At the NELTAS International English Language Competition, Inaya Khan of grade 2 and Zainab Abbasi from 3A both scored a bingo 100 and obtained the first ranks. 67 students appeared for the SOF Olympiads. Farhana Khan of 4A was awarded the international gold medal for GK, while Zainab Abbasi, also from 4A, won the international bronze medal for English. At the Mars International Spell Bee competition, Inaya Khan of grade 1A secured the second place, while Inaya Patel from 3A secured the third place in their respective categories. Students appeared for the Logic Kids Mental Aptitude Test, where Isna Merchant of 2A secured a state rank of 3. Tanisha Halai of 2B secured a state rank 5, and a special mention of Arham Bansali from 1B who secured a state rank of 8. Congratulations and well done, children. Staying updated is the key to success in any field. Our teachers constantly strive to stay informed about the latest. Each staff member attended numerous webinars, workshops and training programs through the year. These included subjects specific to general ones such as working on software skills, on soft skills, building of IT skills, safety SOPs and protocols, to name a few. Along with some of these being conducted in-house, many teachers attended training conducted by the Cambridge, the IB organization, MISA, and received various certificates. All teachers made us proud, while a few teachers brought accolades too. Ms. Sarah Shah was awarded Teacher of the Year 2021 by Campus Mall for innovative teaching and exceptional contribution made to student learning while working in the face of adversity. On Teachers' Day, HarperCollins awarded 6 of our teachers in different categories as listed on the slides. And the teachers who were awarded are Ms. Asta, Ms. Mubina, Ms. Eureka, Ms. Vidya, Ms. Candida, and Ms. Avanti. Well done, teachers. On 20th October, at a function held in Mumbai, yours truly, the principal, was recognized by Education World as the exemplary COVID pandemic edu leader of the year 2021. Thank you for that contribution. Thank you, teachers, for making us all proud. Students were given ample opportunity in the virtual space to explore, build confidence, and develop a variety of skills through activities and by creating an environment for a practical approach towards learning. Some of the student enrichment programs included children pledging to look after our Mother Earth on the Earth Day in April. Practicing yoga reminded us that fitness is the key to a happy and healthy life. CPGS turned 21 years old on 19th June this year, and it was time to remember and thank the founders and reiterate the mission of the institution. Languages and deeper understanding of history and culture of its origins was discussed across grades by celebrating the French and Spanish days, while Hindi Divas was celebrated in September. Building leadership qualities and empowering students to have a say in school are some of the main objectives of having a student council. House captains and vice captains were chosen democratically through an election process. Houses nominated their candidates who campaigned, made speeches, and finally students voted for their leaders. The newly elected members of the student council took up their responsibilities post the virtual investiture ceremony held on 17th of July. July was also time to remember the sacrifice and salute the brave heart martyrs on the 21st anniversary of Kargil Vijay Divas. 15th August this year, India celebrated its 75th Independence Day. All sections of the school had a series of activities. Learners of IBDP and A levels through a declamation competition remembered some of those who had fought for the independence of our great land, Mother India. Lit Polis. The basic purpose of the Lit Polis Week was to provide an exposure to a range of literary work from the modern to the old masters. In September, students of preschool to secondary displayed their creative side by recreating and enacting their versions of their favorite classic stories. In the secondary, debates, writing reports and blogs were some of the activities conducted through the year. Sorry, I beg your pardon, through the week. The tiny tots of the pre-primary and primary too had a busy, filled calendar. They learned concepts by virtual events like the Sense Booth, Little Master Chef. They celebrated Friendship Day, Eid, danced on Navratri, and participated in Diya and Rangoli making, and had a fancy dress competition on Diwali. Then came Christmas last year, and it was time to sing jingles and welcome Santa. On 2nd October, the students of the school paid homage to the father of our nation, remembering Gandhiji's teachings and taking his legacy forward was discussed. Students took a virtual tour of the Sabarmati Ashram and the Gandhi Museum. 14th November is the birth anniversary of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, which is also celebrated as the Children's Day. And it was a day when the teachers sent virtual messages to show their love and send good wishes to all the students in their care. On the World Indigenous Day, the language department of the IBDP organized a virtual free trip to the cinemas. Then came the time to say good luck and celebrate the graduation days for the students of both grade 10 and senior KG. Also, with pride but a little heaviness in our hearts, we bid farewell to our first batch of IBDP learners. Holistic education includes creating awareness about academics and should also tap into the the social and emotional quotient of students. Some other student activities that we conducted this year, in the year that went by, was like conducting weekly theme-based assemblies, using CAS for generous activities. Grades 11 and 12 applied the CAS experiences and they participated in a crowdfunding through social media campaign in order to collect money for the families in need during the COVID-19 times. 71,000 rupees was collected through this campaign. The students then supported 255 families by distributing ration packets. A student of IBTP used the CAS to bring awareness about hygienic sanitation. She painted colorful coasters and sold them in order to collect money to buy sanitary napkins for young girls. Digital Ayman was also one activity that our students participated. Learners got an experience of the United Nations procedures, international relations, world diplomacy and globalization. With pride, I share about a little bit insight on CPGIS Unplugged, our school's e-newsletter, each edition of which is designed and collated by an extremely dedicated and promising student editorial board. Learners Cafe is again an informal platform which was given to the students of the secondary, the high secondary, to meet and discuss topics that they want to explore. I'm very happy to share that the virtual functioning of the school did not deter the institution to add on more programs which would enrich the learning environment of the students. Some new initiatives that were included this year, the first of those included was giving a virtual lab experience across all subjects. Also, access was given to students for e-library, to the e-library. Practically, across all subjects, teachers conducted virtual field trips. We arranged resource persons. It's always more meaningful, we feel, if classroom teaching is connected with the real world, and specialists from various fields were invited to address students on a variety of topics. The Luke Cutillo Healthy Lifestyle Program, an interactive program, has been introduced for the learners of grade 5 to 10, and the objective is to help them understand the importance of a healthy lifestyle and how they can adopt these life practices in their day-to-day lives. To support the higher secondary students with their learnings, the school has engaged with companies like Kaleido and Turnitin to make informed subject choice and thus career choices. The school has tied up with iSchool Connect. The students get exposure through the iSchool Connect platform to help them secure admissions to their dream universities. From the students, I'd like to now focus a little bit about what more did we do with the staff this year. So a few of staff engagement programs. As mentioned earlier, each staff member attended several workshops and training programs through the year. However, in the light of the raging pandemic, which has disrupted all spheres of our lives, our focus this year for all our stakeholders, including teachers, has been healing and collaboration. Programs such as yoga and meditation, fun-filled hangout sessions were planned each month. Then came September. Teachers' Day celebration in September was an elaborate virtual affair. The Student Council, along with members of the PTA, planned special programs which were lovingly put up by the students and parents. Month-end birthday celebrations were also times to look forward to. I now next move to our very important next stakeholder, you, the parents. We understand the role of parents along with the school in helping to create a conducive learning space for the children in our care. We place a lot of importance in maintaining cordial relationship with parents and like to keep them informed of all the major happenings in school. Hence, many parent orientations with different objectives were organized through the year. From March 2021 through June, orientations were conducted to give an overview of how the year would unfold for your child. Orientations were conducted to give parents and students clarity about both home and board examinations. A series of parent orientations were conducted to explain the protocol put in place by the school for reopening post-COVID pandemic. The periodic virtual PTMs that were conducted through the year provided an opportunity for a two-way communication between teachers and parents and thus helped create a good opportunity to interact face-to-face on all issues concerning the progress of your wards. Using the virtual medium, a PTA executive body was democratically formed in July 2021. We are confident that this PTA body will help create a strong bond between the school and parents. We thank the members of the PTA for your time and efforts you put in through the year. Starting today, I need to forget what's gone. Appreciate what still remains and look forward to what's coming next. I love these lines. With the blessing of the Almighty, currently the pandemic seems to be in control and the state education departments go ahead. With that, the school has reopened post-COVID in a staggered manner after 18 months. First, the teachers were welcomed and then the students of grades 8 to 12 started coming to school from 12th of October. In the past 2 weeks, we have witnessed a range of emotions in both our children and staff. The joy of seeing and hearing the laughter of the children is difficult to explain. Parents, your reinforcement in our educational ideology is leading to the evolution of the institution at an encouraging pace. We appreciate all the feedback that you keep sending to us. The admissions for the academic year 2022-23 across all grades are in progress, and we are encouraged by the interest shown by the prospective parents. Personally today, I'd like to take this occasion to thank you, dear parents, and my heartfelt gratitude to each of my staff members for all the support that you've shown me through these tough times. I end by these lines. Life isn't meant to be easy. It's meant to be lived. Sometimes happy, other times rough. But with every up and down, you learn lessons that make you strong. Thank you. Take precautions. Stay safe. Enjoy the performances of the children. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your kind words. Today, we had an opportunity to hear your thoughts, and this will surely encourage us in our future events. Parents and my dear fellow learners, I know you are excited for the show. But before we start, I want to tell you something about our concert today. It was a really difficult job to put our show up live. But as you know, where there's a will, there's a way. With the hard work and the dedication of our beloved teachers, our most talented students and our supportive parents, our plans went very smoothly. Though we missed the actual performance on stage together, we still enjoyed practicing the same online. Getting things wasn't easy. deciding songs on scripts, characters, dance moves, everything was a novel experience. Since we did not have the advantage of being present in school, though we missed the rehearsal in our auditorium, we still had a virtual zero period of online rehearsals. So after crossing countless hurdles, we all as a team are able to put up colorful show for you and to take you through this beautiful experience. We have our junior captains as narrators. The nation is indebted to all doctors, nurses and other health workers who have been frontline warriors in this fight against the coronavirus. These are the main ideal service warriors of our nation.
Yes, so true. But amid the COVID-19 pandemic, not only doctors, nurses and war boys, but our police department, our army, delivery person, ration shop owners, vegetable fruit vendors, etc. have also played a crucial role by providing us timely access to all the necessary items important for our survival during all the months of the pandemic.
So here are our CPGIS learners to thank these corona warriors and helpers who have been making our lives smooth during this ongoing pandemic. So my friends and I would like to take you on a journey to pay a tribute to these corona warriors. So we call upon grade 4B learners to present with their performance.
Good morning to all of you. Hope you are doing well and are safe at home. Today many of us are safe, but we are safe because of some God sent saviors. Today let us all meet them and understand the worries of their life. Let me take you to Raman's house where we shall meet all of them.
Oh mother, what is this? All day you are only watching news on TV. Don't you ever get bored? All day they only tell us about how many died in violence, in accidents, and now this deadly coronavirus. Don't you find it depressing?
Oh dear, I know. It is depressing to watch sad news. But we need to be updated, especially now in this pandemic. We need to know what we can do to stay safe.
Oh mom, it's the same thing. Wear your mask, wash your hands and practice social distancing.
No Raman, it's not only the precautions, but we also need to know the hardships that people are facing during these tough times, especially frontline workers.
Frontline workers? Who are they?
All our doctors, nurses, ward boys, cleaners, policemen, our frontline workers. They all are battling this war selflessly. They are our COVID warriors.
The next day, Raman is playing and his mother is watching TV.
Raman, come fast. There is a show on the news channel and all our corona warriors are coming on the show to share their experience. Let's watch it. We'll know the difficulties they face in their daily routine.
This is Riyam Strala and welcome to Fast News Express.
Good morning. I am Augusta Sawe, reporting from Fast News Express, Mumbai. Today, the whole world is grappling with the COVID-19 pandemic. Amongst all, the most arduous situations are being faced by our frontline workers. So today, let's meet our COVID warriors and the challenges that they are facing amidst these problematic situations.
We now have with us today Dr. Sachin Mehta from G.V. Ben Hospital, Ahmedabad, Assistant Mumbai Police Commissioner, Mr. Shivarao Patil, and Ms. Roni Pereira from Holy Cross Hospital, Mumbai.
A very good morning to all of you. Dr. Sachin, I now request you to address the nation regarding the tough times that are prevalent today and the challenges that the doctors are facing.
And thank you for giving me this opportunity today. Thousands of people are fighting this deadly disease. Initially, it was a proud moment for me to be posted in a corona ward but I feared that my family may be affected because of me. But for me, my profession is before everything. I guess we all are facing challenges in our own way. But yes, as doctors, we are the ones at more risk as we are coming in contact with corona patients daily. We are working non-stop for 12 hours and sometimes even more. Once we wear our PPE kit, we cannot remove it for 6 hours because it is expensive and cannot be reused. There is not enough intake of oxygen because of the mask. This results in fatigue and other health issues. Moreover, there are patients and their relatives who do not cooperate well. It does not end here. We go through the painful memories of the patients who have died and we have not been able to help them. So yes, it is a sad scenario, but we shall overcome it.
Next, we have Commissioner Shivrao Patil. Welcome, sir. Can you begin by giving us an insight of how the police department has been handling the situation at their end and what are the challenges faced by you?
Thank you. I would first of all like to thank the public for cooperating with us in these difficult times. But nevertheless, my department faces problems by some of the members of the society who do not follow the rules laid down by the government. I would request you all to please avoid social gathering, wear your mask, wash your hands and maintain social distancing. We need to understand that the need of the hours to protect oneself instead of the police department patrolling in the town to monitor everyone else. We have to take strict measures to keep the public indoors. These precautions are not for the personal benefit of the police. They are to keep you safe. So stay home and stay safe. The corona has not gone yet, but we will fight against it and come out victorious. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. Now quickly, we move on to Miss Rosie, who is a nurse. Miss Rosie, what has your experience been like during the COVID-19 pandemic?
In this COVID, we have faced many difficulties. During the second wave, we had many critical patients who needed a lot of attention and care. We have witnessed shortage of beds, shortage of oxygen for patients. We have not met our families as we do not want to expose them to the possibility of being affected as we are exposed to COVID patients. There has also been a shortage of staff at times due to which each one of us has been overworked. But God willing, I am sure we shall emerge victorious in this battle.
Thank you, Ms. Rosie, Dr. Sachin, and Commissioner Shivrao Patil for being here with us today. Good luck, stay safe, and all the best. I, Riyan Srala, and
I, Augustus Sawe, signing off for today. See you all again tomorrow in the fastest news channel, Fast News Express. Have a good day.
Oh, Mama, I did not know people are going through so much trouble.
It's not only them, but there are more unsung heroes who are working hard against all odds.
Who are they, Mama?
Working from home has been a roller coaster ride. We haven't had issues balancing home and school work. Many times we find it difficult. Screen time has increased, which has led to fatigue and other health issues. We are hoping to see our little angels as soon as the pandemic is over. Love you all.
I think we should value your teachers' efforts and listen to them.
But Mother, we have to miss out so much.
I miss going to school with so many fun activities. I'm missing them all. Above all, I'm missing my friends, teachers, and everybody in school.
So let us all wish that this pandemic ends soon.
Come on, let's push it out.
Hi friends, I am Akshay. I too am a COVID warrior as I have fought this disease. Friends, from my experience, I can tell you that this disease should not be taken lightly. Please follow the precautionary measures. Remember, COVID has not gone yet. Stay alert to the symptoms and above all, get vaccinated and be safe. I thank all COVID warriors, our heroes, from the bottom of my heart. All of you out there, let's bow our heads and shout out a big thank you to our COVID heroes.
That was indeed a beautiful performance by our CPGIS learners. Let's give them a big round of applause.
Do you know that my neighbor and his whole family are tested positive for corona? Just think about all of those corona patients. What were they going through and what were the feelings and emotions at that particular time?
Oh, really? The same in my neighborhood as well. I can't even imagine what were they going through. They all have fought against this life-threatening viruses and all they have overcome it. Indeed, they are the real heroes. To present with a tribute, I call grade 2B learners for the performance.
दिखला दे जिंदा है तू, बाकी है तुझ में हौसला। तेरी जुनू के आगे अंबर पनाहे मांगे, कर डाले तू जो फैसला।
रूठी तकदीरे तो क्या, टूटी शमशीरे तो क्या, टूटी शमशीरों से ही हो।
हर मैदान पते रे बंदे, हर मैदान। thanks to all your doctors and nurses for all your efforts to take care of people suffering from the coronavirus. We admire you greatly. To present a tribute to our nation's doctors and nurses, here are our grade 3A learners with their dance performance.
कुछ पाने की हो आस आस कोई अरमा हो जो खास खास आशाएं हर कोशिश में हो बार बार करे दरियाओं को आर पार आशाएं तूफानों को चीर के मंजिलों को छीन ले अपने संग तुझको वहां जन्नत से मुलाकात हो पूरी हो तेरी हर दुआ आशाएं खिले दिल की उम्मीदें हंसे दिल की अब मुश्किल नहीं कुछ भी नहीं कुछ भी गुजरे ऐसी हर रात रात हो ख्वाहिशों से बात बात आशाएं लेकर सूरज से आग आग गाए जा अपना राग राग आशाएं कुछ ऐसा करके दिखा खुद खुश हो जाए खुदा
during this difficult time. Your kindness and strength is greatly appreciated. Thank you so much for being our nation's guiding light in the face of the pandemic.
In what dilemma are you, my dear friend?
I'm thinking, what about we as common people have contributed to support against the fight of coronavirus?
Of course, we have contributed a lot by going out whenever it was necessary, by wearing a mask whenever going out, always carrying a hand sanitizer, and most importantly, keeping 2-meter distance. Along with those famous celebrities, common people have also contributed to the well-being of the corona patients.
Yes. You are right. Along with the celebrities, many common people have also contributed to the well-being of corona patients. So here are a grade 1A learner with their performance.
सुनो गौर से दुनिया वालों, बुरी नजर ना हम पे डालो। सुनो गौर से दुनिया वालों, बुरी नजर ना हम पे डालो, चाहे जितना जोर लगा लो, सबसे आगे होंगे हिंदुस्तानी। गौर से दुनिया वालों, बुरी नजर ना हम पे डालो, चाहे जितना जोर लगा लो, सबसे आगे होंगे हिंदुस्तानी।
हिंदुस्तानी
हमने कहा है, तुम भी कहो। हमने कहा है जो, तुम भी कहो।
आओ हम मिलजुल के बोले, अब तो यारा अपना जहां है सबसे प्यारा।
Of life. So I call up on grade 3 the learners with their performance.
This song is for those who inspire us today, who always lend a helping hand to help show us the way. This song is for those who see their students through the tough times in their lives. For that we say thank you. You have made a difference. You have shaped our minds. You have changed the world, one child at a time. You have always been there in everything you do. I hope that you wipe tears from the children's eyes. For those who gave us a safe place to grow, a place for us to call our home forever, we will know that you have made a difference. You have shaped our minds. You have changed the world, one child at a time. You have always been there in everything you do. I hope that you're as proud of me as I am proud of you.
That was a spectacular performance.
At a Majlis Satakli.
Whoa! What's wrong with you?
Nothing. Just imagining the status of our police department when we, the common people, were not adhering to the rules set by the government for our society.
So true. Surely the police department played a major role in making us follow the rules and regulations. So here are our grade 1A learners with their performance to give a tribute to the police department.
Oh,
virus is attacking all of us as mankind, and this is going to call all of us to be reunited as we fight back. And I believe as we fight back, we will bounce back.
Our condition will not be our conclusion. And we are in this together, and we will get through this together. Now we have our grade 2A learners who will be presenting a motivational song.
Yeah. दे चल दे, कभी हाथ छुड़ा के मैं तेरा चल दूं चल दूं। मैं थोड़ी सी मूढ़ी हूँ, तू थोड़ी सी टेढ़ी है, क्या खूब ये जोड़ी है तेरी मेरी। आने दो आने दो दिल में आ जाने दो, ये दो मुस्कुराहट को हाय 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 हाय। जाने दो दिल से चले जाने दो, ये दो घबराहट को बाय 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 बाय।
Miss Ritu Dubey to give you the vote of thanks. Miss Ritu, all over to you.
Dear all, greetings of the day. I extend a sincere gratitude to our honorable trustees, Sandeep Goenka sir and Archana Goenka ma'am, for gracing the occasion with their valuable presence. They have always motivated with their inspiring words and wholehearted support. I offer my heartfelt gratitude to Ms. Deepa Bhushan for joining us today, for all the timely motivation throughout and her constant reassurance that Team CPGIS together can overcome all the hurdles with consistency, resilience and smile on our faces. I offer sincere appreciation to Ms. Manju Mehta for being involved and guiding us through the detailing and in-depth planning of this event to become a success. We have been fortunate enough to be backed with timely guidance of Ms. Monica, Ms. Swati and Ms. Sheetal. Dear section heads, admin head, our public relations officer, thank you so much for all the efforts on and off campus for creating such a beautiful show and event today. Events like these are not possible without your strong support and relentless working for the progress of our learners. Thank you so much for making the online learning so engaging and fun for all the students in last 18 months. A huge round of applause to the IT team for taking care of the smallest details with minimum time and compiling the entire show so beautifully. And most importantly, the pillars of today's events, all our learners of CPGIS. No event is possible without their inputs, their energy and enthusiasm. A big thank you to all the students who took part in today's event and charming us with your wonderful performances. And last but not the least, dear parents, thank you so much for attending the event and putting tons of efforts taken by you on an individual capacity with costumes, retakes, makeup and much more. Thank you so much everyone for joining us.
Shine.